Hey dudes, so I'm up here at the HV today. I'm here in the woods. I got the 450. I still haven't even cleaned it up from going to the motocross track down on High Desert MX. We made a sag change for those of you guys that watch my midweek maintenance. I think I already talked about it, but we found out that the sag on the bike was really messed up. The sag is supposed to be 105-ish area, and when we checked it, it was actually like 96, 98, somewhere in that range. So instead of just flopping the forks like I was thinking of doing, we decided we'd go ahead and set the sag and then go ride it and see. Well, I'm not used to motocross, so while the bike seemed like it was handling really good on the motocross track, I really need to get back up here in the woods and hit some single track, hit some tight stuff, and see if it's handling well there. And that will let me know if it was the sag problem, the bike was too stink bug, too rear high, and it wouldn't cut into the corners good, which so far that feels like what it was. It seemed like it really planted well at the motocross track, seemed like I could lean it in real good. It didn't seem like it had a tendency to straighten itself up like it was before, but that may all be because the balance was wrong. It had too much sag in the rear, and or too little sag in the rear, I should say, and the rear end was never settling down. So when we had checked both the sags, we did it on the 250 and the 450. The 250 was set at like 114 or something. Like, it was super sagged down. So I don't want to have to go that low. I don't want, you know, to try and set this bike up that way. I think we ended up going 106, 107. Maybe it was 108. Something like that. Just a little bit more than the 105, but not quite 114. I didn't want to go that far. So today is that day. I'm going to go up. I'm going to go rip. No GoPro, no action cam or nothing. Not gonna video it. Just want to go up, get a quick after work rip, feel what it feels like, and then I'll report back to you guys if we are doing a fork swap or if I'm gonna recommend for people to check their sag more often, one or the other. All right guys, let's go get it. So one of the other cool things that I had happen this weekend while we were at the motocross track, I know you guys skipped out, you don't even know where we're at. I went for a ride up the trail, remembered, drove back so I get my tool. So this weekend I was able to get my buddy Ralph. He's an A rider, really good rider, knows what you're supposed to feel on a bike. I actually had him ride the 450 on the motocross track, not to see if it fits him because he's way lighter than I am, shorter than I am, but just in general, is the bike feeling right? Am I way off on the setup, or is it pretty close? You know, is it doing what it needs to be doing? And we actually swapped. He let me ride his KTM, I think it was a 350, 300, 350, it was a four stroke. I think it's a 350 KTM. Anyhow, we swapped. And so in my race review, you'll hear me say, one of those jumps bucked me and almost scorpioned me, like the rear end is bouncy. Well, when he got done riding the 450, that's the same thing he said, that the rear in feels like it pops up really quick, that the rebound might be too soft and might need to stiffen up the rebound a little bit, which I already did when I very first got the suspension back, but I haven't done anything with it since. So I wanted to come back down, throw two clicks into it, two clicks stiffer on the rebound. Maybe that will settle the rear end down a little bit, keep the rear end from bouncing up and hit me in the butt. I noticed it up on here on one of the little jumps I was going over. Nothing bad, I've gotten used to it, but if I can get it to actually come out of the suspension, that'd be even better. So, one second. There we go. But if I can get it to actually come out of the suspension, have it where it doesn't like to do that, that would be even better. So we're going to go try that, see what that does, and see how it helps. And if it doesn't help, or if it keeps doing it, then we'll go a little further. But I have a feeling two clicks should calm it down a little bit. But yeehaw, let's go. All right, guys. So the ride is over. Went real well. No issues, no problems. So two things. One, the two clicks on the rebound. Perfect. Thank you, Ralph. You're the man. It settled the rear end right down instead of all the little knobs sticks, twigs. It always has a pop to the rear end. It always has had. I just thought that was an active rear end. You know, it's following the ground. It's whatever. But those two clicks of tightening the rebound slowed it down, where now it doesn't do that. It feels smoother over all that stuff, especially with me, where I ride with my weight back a lot. So, awesome. Another thing about the ride is, I didn't even think about it till I was almost back here, was I aired the tires up for the motocross track. I typically run somewhere between 6 to 8 PSI for the racing and stuff up here in the woods. It literally gives you such amazing traction that wheelie on demand, the tires don't really spin, hill climbs or nothing. It's just amazing traction. But it does hamper turning a little bit. So for the motocross track, I decided I was gonna air it up tighter. So I think I went to 15, which probably could have got away with 12 or something, but I didn't change the air pressure at all today. And riding around, air pressure is a part of this too. So the sag definitely made a big difference. So I guess I should have started with that. It handles wonderful. It handles great. Going through the tight woods and stuff, I'm able to flick it back and forth just like the 250. It was all set up. So one, the sag being wrong, having it too stink bug, the rear end too high, because I ride on the back of the bike, it made it where it didn't want to turn in good, it didn't handle good. So getting the sag set up better, lower, correct, you know, or better. I might even play around with going a little bit more sag, but we'll see. But between that and the air pressure in the tires and the two clicks stiffer on the rebound, yeah, it's handling good. Felt way better. I got it, you know, hoping to get one more ride on the 250 this week after work, just so I can have the apples to oranges. Is it gotten there, or is it still just a little off? And what can I do to try and get that last little bit? Having Ralph ride the bike and give me his opinion on it is huge. Nobody else that has real experience with suspension or racing, riding fast, knowing what it's supposed to feel like, has ever ridden the bikes. So I didn't know if I was on track, off track, whatever. So having his assessment and his thoughts on it helped me dial it in a little more. It's the best it's been so far. That's not to say that we're done clicking around and fine-tuning, but it's handling real good. I'm loving it. I won't say that going to ride on the MX track is what helped it all, but partially, I guess. I wouldn't have put that much air pressure in the tires or tubeless to come up here and ride the trails. I really like having the low pressure and high traction for the trails, so that part of it did help. I also didn't notice, there's not too many hill climbs, but it's pretty dusty and dry today. And with the air pressure up higher, I didn't notice any real super bad loss of traction. You have to understand that you don't have the really squishy tire to hit when you hit the roots and stuff. So I imagine it would spin out more, especially if it was wet, if it was raining, mud, any of that. You want low pressure. But dry, hard ground, get away with high pressure, no problem. And sure made a difference in the handling between that and the sag and the rebound. So loving it, guys. We're getting there, and the 450 is finally starting to handle the way I want it to, or closer to the way I want it to. Dialing it in, man. It's been so long since we had a race that I've had to go find interesting things to go do just so I can try and improve my riding and improve the bike and get to where I want it to be. Typically, I would be fighting all this stuff through the races. Adjust a little bit for a race, go ride it, see how that worked, adjust it a little bit. And that's what I've done all so far this season. So going racing motocross and going out and trail riding, going out doing anything to get some time on the bike and some seat time and feel it out helps out. So sorry I didn't bring the GoPro with you guys, but you've seen this OHV a million times, you've seen these trails a million times, and this was just kind of me checking it out. I think this is the way that I'm gonna leave the bike for racing for the rest of the year. I'm not gonna do the fork swap until after the races are done, and I might do it just for fun to swap the forks and see. It's riding good enough now that I told myself if I could just get it handling good enough and riding the way I wanted to, that I wasn't going to change anything. So it's there now, or we're almost there. So I'm not going to change the forks unless my ride on the 250 is just like mind blowing good and it's so much better. But the 450 is getting pretty good, guys. So, all right, hope you guys enjoy the short little update. And yeehaw! I suppose this is what we all kind of do with our bikes, going through trying to find our setup, trying to find the way we want the bike to be and how to get the bike to handle for us. I suppose everybody goes through it, but me being newer to bikes, man, like last year, I just rode the fucking bike. I didn't know anything about changing clickers and, you know, air in the tire. I just, half the races I did on a flat tire. So this year I'm trying to learn. I'm trying to educate myself, trying to figure out how all this stuff works and get the bike set up the way I want it. So keep at it, guys. Whoop, whoop.